we've been organizing since we've registered over 400 voters. We've built a social media presence on Facebook with over 1,200 people. We've been raising money to print flyers and get the word out about Bernie by selling these t-shirts, giving away lots of stickers so that way people can put it on their cars, pins on their shirts to generate interest there. And just trying to get as many people as possible that are interested in talking about Bernie.
There was some talk about there was another group in Buffalo too. Are we connected to any kind of state for Bernie?
That's a good question. So why don't I do a quick rundown of what the national campaign's up to? We'll work from there. National rundown. The National Sanders campaign is pretty much non-existent. They have a team of lawyers that are going to get Sanders on the ballot, but they don't have any hired people in the state that I'm aware of. You know, it's something I'm paying attention to day by day. This thing is volunteer driven.
Is that right?
Almost every state. You know,
I'm live streaming.
This thing is volunteer driven in almost every state, besides Iowa, New Hampshire, South Carolina. There's no hired staff. So in New York, it's all volunteer driven again. In every city, small community, they've got groups like this that are meeting coffee shops, bars, and people's living rooms, and talking to each other about Bernie and generating interest. So, in the city of Buffalo, Buffalo for Bernie is the only group that I'm aware of in Buffalo, Western New York area. There's other people that are interested, but the legend is that there's another group that I haven't connected to. I'll be on a Facebook page. What's that?
The Clockers.
But, as far as another, functioning group that I'm aware of, outside of social media, there's nothing that I've come across. Not we're the only show in town, but we're the most visible presence, I should say. Right? So, the big thing that we're going to have to do is volunteers to actually get Bernie Sanders eligible to run for president, because we have to get him on the ballot. So, any of you who do political campaigning before, do position work in the past?
Yeah, I have done.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay. So, long and short, what we're going to have to do is get our group of volunteers to go door to door, get the signatures of registered Democrats through each congressional district. And our group is working on two congressional districts, New York 26, represented by Ryan Higgins, and New York 27,
where
Chris
Collins.
What is that? So, 26 is pretty much the city of Buffalo and some of the first ring suburbs. And 27 kind of thing over the horseshoe that surrounds it. It's the South
Towns. Would that be Orchard Park?
Yep.
I live in Orchard Park.
Yeah, you would be part of 27. So Orchard Park, the South Towns, all going up through Batavia, and just east of Niagara Falls. What we have to collect to meet a legal requirement would be 500 signatures from each district. Now, we don't know if all those signatures are going to be valid or not, so we have to get more than a minimum, right? So that way our petitions are guaranteed to be okay. So we're setting our sights on getting 2,500 signatures per congressional district. Think of it like this. If you can look at a petition of 500 signatures, that's a minimum requirement. If you can knock one off, it's no longer a valid petition, right? If you get 2,500, what we could do together on that is so overwhelming. They'll see that the voters are all registered, the addresses are all in order, everything's cleaned up, very professional, well done. They're just going to look at this and say, they got 500 valid signatures. No point challenge.
How are you going to verify information?
Yes. So, we have, if you're a registered Democrat in Erie County, you can go to the election and pick up a list of every registered Democrat. Any of us can do that if they're registered Democrats. And then we can turn that into a block list when we go door to door. We're working with a lawyer who's done this kind of petition work many times before. He's been doing political type work for 40 years. So, he's prepared that this is just another go to and this is how you do it, this is how you go door to door. And he uses a program to where he generates his own style of walk list that's more user friendly than what the Board of Elections has. Peter Reese. Yeah. And the way he generates the walk list is more user friendly. So we have all the resources we need to get this done, except for Pete.
Buffalo bread.
Say 1 year because it's been a while. I still know where it is though. But what about setting something up at the campus where you've got this group of young people that are?
There's a little bit of interest on the campus, but we've had some luck with registering voters and finding some interest. There's no club exactly there. Our group, Buffalo Bernie's, had more success we certainly should just say Buffalo State, not worth organizing. There's a lot of interest, it's just tapping into it. This Friday, if you go to BernieSanders.com, one of the events that's hosted there is a voter registration drive on Buffalo State. So we're going to be there 11:30 to 1 o'clock.
Right now?
We would love some help. So the student union will be meeting there 11:30, registering people, handing out flyers.
Now, where on the campus is the student union?
It's near the center of the campus.
Okay.
If you walk from Elmwood Avenue, there's a diagonal walkway, and that pretty much takes you right to the student union.
Okay.
I don't have a better way to say it than that. But if you find the student union, we'll be on the outside of it, closer to Elmwood Avenue.
So you should find a place that's and there are places where you can go and you can plug money into a meeting.
Yeah, actually, if you there's a sign that says visitor parking, and it takes you in, you make a right hand turn. There's about 20 or 30 parking spaces that you have to buy, put money in there. And if you walk right through that building, you get into the quad and to the unit to the left.
So that's
11:30
on Friday.
Okay.
I'm gonna try it.
Okay, 11:30 to 1 Friday we'll be there registering votes. We've done this twice already, and as I said, we've had some success, but we get the students themselves interested enough to go to campus group. People have had some interest, but no one that wanted to be that law enforcement to make it happen. Yeah, it's just a matter of finding the right person, and it hasn't quite happened yet. But that's the good thing about doing stuff like this, is that Buffalo State alumni come out and we can work together, and
it's such a
hopefully,
right.
I'm sure we'll find somebody to make that happen. But it's as far as our meet and greet here tonight, the big thing I wanted to do was just get a chance for everyone to get a chance to talk with each other, exchange information, share ideas. Why don't we do a go around in a circle and introduce ourselves? And one of the things I like to do is say, what one thing would you change about the country if you had an answer? I'll start. My name is Brian. And the one thing I would change about the country is I would institute a guaranteed minimum income, to make sure that everybody has enough. Want to go next?
I'm John. One thing I would definitely like to see changed is universal health care. I think that's a huge issue.
That's a very interesting one. I haven't heard before. Can you explain briefly what that is? I think that'd be another word for it.
I'm Emmeline.
I'm Ron, and I want to get rid of Citizens United. I just don't like the way they're going to have that. Because you have people that are at a certain point in their campaign just got working. And they have no talent. I mean, it's scary. It really is.
It's scary.
It's
scary.
Hi, I'm Amy.
But I think you have the issue, Ron. We don't take care of Citizens United and the money in politics. We can't do anything. We can't get sustainable energy. Criminal justice reform is not going to happen. Universal health care. It's the overarching issue. Unfortunately, you guys know what Lawrence Lessig is, right? He just dropped out of Drake. Lawrence Lessig, he was running as a Democrat. He's just a single issue guy on Citizens United.
And they stopped putting him on polls so he couldn't get the 1% to get into the debates.
That's really amazing. The last election, there were 17 people running. And some of these, I just go to California, there's a cab driver.
We're doing elections locally today, and I think they're, we're a closed primary. You've got to register to political party, right? We're six parties. So there's pretty much six choices. We want to run. We want to elect. For half the races that I had to vote on, there were 14 races. Seven of them were people that won.
You were down the list of the parties, and there's two candidates, and they're in every single party. So you can actually
that's vote, ridiculous.
Vote for one and vote against the other guy, the next row, he's there again. Yeah, it's like, what?
Because the parties take things from each other.
And it's like, how do we get any of this stuff without, Citizens United making their you guys know Zephyr Teach Out? She ran for governor. She did a talk here last month and talked about public funding of elections, right?
I was in there too.
And so, the history of the way Teach Out covered. How we went about getting, how we can go about getting to public funding elections was great. She talked about all these reforms that were done when people were injecting money into politics over and over and over. And there were these laws that were saying, okay, you can't do this now. So they found a workaround. And they tell lawmakers, you can't do this thing. So the lawmakers found another workaround. And after a while, we don't affirm a fix. We're going to keep having the problem. So we can get Citizens United, the shit is terrible. The issue is, what do we put up to replace it? We haven't done that yet. And that's where public funding of elections comes in. Bernie's been talking about that on and off, and it's a big part of his platform. So if we don't get public funding in, we're going to have another type of Citizens United put us in. It's a matter of building support and getting people really interested in taking care of something. Because everybody knows it's a problem whether they're conservative or liberal or Democrat or Republican. It's just getting everyone to work together on that one issue. And this country has done these things before where we've agreed we have a problem and we have to solve this issue. Vietnam War is a good example. Oppositions in the whole party. To the war. It took a while to get there.
There's a seat right here if you want to sit closer to us.
It took a while to wrap the war to an end, but there's Democrats and Republicans and liberals and conservatives that wanted to stop it. It was just the people in positions of power, the people in grassroots, wanted this done. It's like the same thing with our campaign finance process. It's just how do we start getting conservative support and interest in joining with the liberals that have been opposed to the beginning, And not to say all conservatives have. You guys get the idea, though. Why don't you introduce yourself, you're multiple people. We went in a circle. I just asked everybody their name, one thing you would change about the country. Only one.
Oh, that's a tough one. Don't do this to me.
Yeah, magic wand.
Well, I'm Sarah. What would I change? It's really hard. Can I take a pass for now? I would change difficult icebreakers.
Difficult icebreakers.
I know, right? I would change a lot of things. It's hard to narrow it down.
What we were talking about before everyone else came over was one of the issues with building political movements is that we organize around a candidate every 4 years. We get a lot of support for them, and then everyone goes, right? And that gets some progress on some issues. What Bernie's been talking about is trying to build a political revolution, which it isn't getting in the streets with your guns and marching up and down like, you know, Soviets or anything like that. It's much different than that. It's the idea of being involved all the time to whatever degree you can be. Voter turnout among millennials, I'm 28, so I'm on one end of that. And 80% of millennials didn't vote in 2014. 4 out of 5 of them stayed home.
That's sad.
Isn't it? Yeah.
Because I'm in the same boat as you. I'm 29.
Right.
Yeah, but I voted a 10 for Tuesday in my district. I was number 30 in my district.
But then you can midterm, you can still turn and get out of why that is. And that's really important because that's when the Senate or the Congress will get up. And it's amazing. It really is.
I think there's like intentional disenfranchisement. It's
in there's a case to be made for that too, you know? We always think about whose interest is it to suppress the vote. You know, if we're supporting Sanders, I think it's safe to say we're left to center, right? You would think the conservatives, the Republicans would be doing that, right? But you get into certain areas where there are Democratic strongholds already, that all they need is a slim part of the public to vote. And then those people can stay in power. You can actually have the issue where too many Democrats are voting, that the establishment of people in these local parties, these town parties, the city parties, lose power. So voter suppression, you kind of mentioned that it could come from the left too, or from the Democratic Party, you know? Because it's not in their interest to have everybody registered. You know? One of the other things that's been getting floated around, California is working on it. Oregon instituted it already. Is automatic voter registration that you turn in and you're already registered to vote. I mean, what do you guys think about that? Do you think that's a good idea?
I mean, I think it's a great idea. I think a lot of these states, specifically the states where, you know, there is a high amount of messages, you're taking away their voting ability, but also releasing places like you have to go through all these different obstacles to vote, so like voter ID laws are becoming more popular now, and like,
they do that here, though. I mean, I just moved from Colorado, and they asked me if I wanted to register the voter. I said, yes. And I got the voter registration to take them back.
Yeah, we do. We've got here just like the voter laws. Yeah, we have motor voters, so at the DMV, when you apply for your license, they ask you to register the voter. Yeah. What Oregon's doing is something more assertive. You turn 18, you're registered. You know? Now, you know, getting something like that done in New York is awesome. You know, and we can work with a lot of people that are interested in move something like that forward. You know? Support for that is cross party lines. I'm sure. But we run into this problem of when we register people automatically in our state, we have a closed primary system, so you have to pick a party. You know, the details wouldn't be so easy, but it's definitely a step in the right direction, and that's something that will help drive forward in our future. But these kind of meetings, they were happening 8 years ago from Barack Obama. Not to do that now, but or they weren't as big or popularized. People were meeting in coffee shops and bars or building support for him too. And it's, like I said, it just died off as everyone went home, you know? Is it that Barack didn't want to keep everyone working and involved in the movement? Was it that the people he asked for help didn't help? I don't know. I wasn't paying attention to something like that, you know? But there's definitely questions worth asking. So, the advantage we have now are these things, you know?
Yeah.
You're recording on a phone right now.
Yeah.
This thing's beautiful, you know? It takes video. You can take pictures.
If anybody doesn't want to be on Periscope, let me know. I'll try to keep you off camera.
Yeah.
You can
connect with people all over the world on this thing. You
know? I just had people from South America support, or yeah, South America supporting us. Dude, like, if we were in America, we'd support you.
That's cool.
I'm just starting to learn about the process.
Yeah. I've been curious about that.
Have you
done any research about it?
So let's imagine our factory took over the local beverage management, right? That Sanders supporters were leading in the party. Now, with a closed primary system, you kind of have one of the advantages would be keeping people out of that party that can screw it up. You know, you already have the people in the party that support a certain candidate, a certain platform, that you don't want them to be able to switch back and forth with ease and influence who the party elects as its chairman, its candidate for governor, or those kind of things. You know, and one of the downsides is that if you want to run as an independent candidate, it's very difficult. You know, you have to pick a party to get on the ballot. You want to switch parties because you have a legitimate change of heart. That tends to be difficult too. You know?
And the problem with doing that is, like, if you want to get into politics and you've been known to switch parties, that's going to haunt you.
Right.
So that'd be tough for, like, me to get into politics because I've switched 2-3 times now. I guarantee somebody would bring that up against me. Like, why are you flip-flopping?
In other states, they have a more open system where you don't have to register your party. Like Virginia and Texas are two examples. You don't have to register your party at all. I believe Virginia, I could be wrong, that it's actually impossible to register your party, you know? So
would influence who the Democratic nominee was. You know, they would use that open primary system to do that, to get in a nominee that they think will actually lose. That would be the strategy.
Right.
And then the general election, they would vote, yeah.
And that's one of the concerns. But now, I would tend to be a supporter myself of the. I would tend to be a supporter myself of a more open primary system, because you can get anyone on the ballot, and if their ideas win the day, they get a majority of voters, and they win. You know. But that's just me. You know. But I mean, you were saying this.
That's assuming that people would just vote for who they really believed in.
That's always a real problem because you have to deal with the totality of the voters. I was living in East Buffalo way back when.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
The guy was running for our district congressman, and he protested.
There's a seat right there.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean,
because the incumbent was listed on top. And he said that's not fair.
I'm already on the list.
How you doing?
Yeah,
come
back. I get a ticket on Hurdle. I used to live on Parkside in Tacoma, but it does say no parking down the fence. But I'm not.
So, you know, those of you who just joined us, give you another clear recap on pretty much what we're going to do right now is that, our group up folks pretty much functioning since June. We've been registering voters, getting the word out, building interest. So we signed in. And building general interest for a local Sanders campaign. Right? In the coming months, we're going to have to pass a petition to get Sanders on the ballot. Have the three of you done any political work for another campaign before this? So
what do you mean, get on the ballot? If you vote for the primary, he's on the ballot.
Yeah, we have to do the actual groundwork of getting him on the ballot itself. We have to collect signatures to register Democrats.
To get him on the New York State ballot?
That's right. So we have to get 500 signatures to register Democrats.
When does the process start?
There's a window for them. And it begins December 29th. and then ends on February 4th. So,
so you mean he might not even get on New York State ballot?
He will.
Hillary doesn't have to do that, does she?
Every Democrat has to do that.
Hillary has to do that too.
Yeah, the thing is he will get on the ballot. We just want to get as many people as possible to help make it happen. The state of Alabama just did this type of process. They had to get a minimum number of signatures to get standards on the Alabama ballot. They got it. Yeah.
How many do you need for 500?
We need a minimum of 500, which we're going to go much more than that.
Yeah. You said registered Democrats?
Registered Democrats. Because we're
looking at just registered voters.
Because of the way our primary system works, where it's a closed primary, you have to get people that are in the party that are going to endorse the candidate.
Okay.
So that's pretty much how it
works. So if they say, well, I don't really like him, and they won't sign it for that reason?
They could.
They could say, well, I really want Hillary. Well, this isn't to vote. And then you're going to say, well, I'm not going to sign it.
Right.
Yeah.
To get the signature we need, it's something that will happen. It's just... How quickly do we do it? How much stress do we place on the people, right? If we get 50 to 100 each person collects 20, 30 signatures, we're done. We got it.
Yeah.
Right?
What's that? The register? Do you have any burning material? I have some in my car. I got things to hand out to people.
Well, for anyone that's interested, I've got T-shirts for sale, $20 a pop.
I've got three of them.
And I've got rings of stickers for anybody that would like one of those.
Do you have any little brochures that show Bernie's agenda? I got a few, and
I don't
want to. Yeah.
I don't have any with me now.
And I printed some on my own computer, but it's expensive. No.
Oh, yeah.
I got a lot. I got 50 or 40
pages. I'll pass the box around. If anybody wants to take a picture, feel free.
I'll take another bumper sticker. I have one. So is there a risk he won't get on the ballot? That's what you're saying. It could happen.
Technically, he wouldn't get on. But there's so much interest locally for Bernie, and so many people that are working on this kind of stuff that they're attending the meetings. That's not happening. We just want to make sure we have dozens of volunteers going to their neighborhoods and collect those signatures.
Do you have a form for them to sign a petition? Any sample forms?
I don't have one with me.
Yeah, because if I want to, I have a list of Democratic voters in my area, which is in Austin. But I have a list. There's 400 something. I'm surprised, but.
We're going to have to collect signatures from that, all over the place. We're going to get the minimum.
But you don't have the same thinking chance. How are we going to get the petitions?
There's a petition window. So we won't have to be ready until the 29th of
December. Oh, okay.
So, a big part of what's going on right now is just trying to make people aware of the process. Let them know when the window is.
All right.
Let them know.
And we'll have till February 2nd?
February 4th. You don't want to get ready to finalize your research paper on the last day, right? You want to have your research paper done in 10 days or more. Then you do your petitioning process. We get all the submissions you need. We sent those petitions off to coordinators, and then we eventually put a couple of pages on the set. Give it to the board of main campus. And work.
All right. So you're gonna email those to us?
Now it's all there.
We're gonna just find. You're gonna notify us that we're in.
BernieSanders.com. You guys have all been to the Bernie Sanders website. So if you go to BernieSanders.com/events. You could look to see what's going on here. BernieSanders.com, type that in. Or BernieSanders.com/events. I'll show you what's going on here. And when we start organizing these petition drives, you can go on to that link and sign up there. Another way to do it would be to take Facebook.
Buffalo for Burning is on Facebook, and we've got over 1,200 people that are following them. That's another way to get connected and get ready for that process. Yet another way is if you text work 2-6-2-3.
So if you go to burningcampus.com, you can sign up for the Sanders email.
No, I did not, unfortunately. I heard 826. What was the...
Repeat the
texting
number?
That's right. Then they keep you in the loop of what's going on with the local fantasy camp.
Yeah, not even just local.
Oh yeah, with the national fantasy camp. I'm sorry.
No, you get. Now he was supposed to give a speech on what is Democratic Socialism. Did you give it?
Still working on it.
Yeah, I thought I saw it on YouTube. And it was at the University of Chicago. I said, I hope this is a
nice
speech. Ah, yeah. They give you general Bernie
information. So, let's say Bernie's going to be on a national show. I think they're all live or something like that. You can text your phone to see what's going on. But once he gets out of the phone, we start doing the actual. The most important aspects of getting Sanders physically on the ballot, getting the nuts and bolts, particularly to Bernie, who runs the petition here. You get a text from the campaign to let you know there's events in your area, how to get more involved, you know?
And the Buffalo for Bernie will have, like, as far as getting petitions, where to get the blank ones. Will you tell me on that, Buffalo for Bernie?
We will be using BernieSanders.com to host the events. And then we'll be organizing the volunteers to meet at a location.
How you doing?
Here for the Bernie meeting? Let's get you a chair.
Hey,
Mike,
you
know what happened to that so-called march on Washington, which I was trying to sign up for that. And I couldn't sign up on the BernieSanders.com. You know anything about that? I'm trying to have a march and he would come.
How's it going?
All right,
Jack. Nice to meet you. As far as Bernie Sanders National goes, for those of you who just got here, Sanders National Campaign is pretty much non-existent in New York.
Really?
So, yeah. So us volunteers, the grassroots volunteers, Pete and Ellen Reese can attest to this. They've been to a number of our local Buffalo for Bernie meetings. We've been around before. Us volunteers, we're the campaign pretty much. So anything we're going to do on the ground to register voters, mobilize people, get them to know more about Bernie. We're the face of that campaign. This is all volunteer driven right now. To my knowledge, there is no hired staff in the state. There's some lawyers on reserve that are ready to work on this petitioning stuff, but it's all us.
Are they going to change that, or is that because he figures New York is forget it? He's not going to forget it.
No, not at all. Closer to where
we're not going for Hillary. Right.
Yeah. Closer to where this petition window opens, that's going to change. But, Sanders is running a campaign where he's not taking big money, right? So he only has so much to work with, and he's focusing on Iowa and New Hampshire, right? So is there going to be money for a state like New York?
Uh-huh.
Not so much. So
the money. New York State's primary is people like him.
Yep.
The key, though, is getting him on the ballot, getting the signatures, firing us, intelligence. One of the things that, frankly, Obama wanted years ago a gal named Hillary. Spent all her money up front early. And she had big plans for those little states. And they never got any
gallery. No, I already heard that. The Democratic primary is April 19th.
Right.
Correct. For him, between him and Hillary
and anybody else that qualify for the ballot.
The guy from Baltimore, forgot him already.
And you know
O'Malley.
But what it's going to come down to is every congressional district, we need to get X number of states them by state. You know, let's say in one congressional district we get enough.
We are in 26.
I understand. You know, I'm saying one we get enough, and let's say that in one of those colleges and you don't get enough. That's what we're going to be dealt with. So even if we did great in the state, because he's on the ballot, we got delegates on the ballot.
The delegates are picked by the congressional district.
Correct.
The goals for Bernie.
Right. So the petitions that we'll be passing, to where we get the 500 signatures minimum per congressional district, we're going to be putting not only Bernie Sanders on the ballot, we're going to be putting five delegates from each congressional district as well.
Now, the other thing is that you don't need just 500.
Dave, will you see Bernie Sanders on?
Bernie Sanders' name will be on the petition.
Okay. Will he be on the ballot?
Yes, his name will be on the ballot, but
you're electing delegates.
You're actually electing.
Okay, the delegates. I bet you I have to just get informed on this. The delegates are by the congressional district. I'm in Collins, and I'm on all of them. So I can get. I got 400 something. 81. I got all the lists from a bunch of Democrats. But that's what I wondered. If Bernie doesn't get it, who will get that? I mean, it's a Republican district in Collins.
It's all in Bristol.
That's not Republican Democrats. And April 19th, we as Democrats, we pick off our candidates by congressional district. Sometimes, again, I don't put a lot in here, but
thank you for
telling me. You have to look at that, but some of it's professional. And I know he's a winner take all. I'm not sure if it's New York.
Is it in Northern Winds, New York? It's all the delegates in New York?
That's a winner take all.
Yeah.
Congressional means you get 40% in congressional district. You get 40% of the delegates. In this case, 2/5. What you want to do is you want to get it, they got to be good. You want to go over more than enough. Because believe me, not only will the Hillary people be looking at it, so will the Board of Elections. Erie County Democratic Committee is trying to throw our solution off.
Which is why you need obviously more than the 500.
Right.
Because you want to make it so that nobody bothers to check.
We need double if you can get it. We got Peter. Peter's one of the best election lawyers in the country.
Yeah, I pride myself on beating you when he's throwing you off.
Yeah, I win my cases easier. I'm a professional person. I've been doing politics since 1982.
We don't know what it is yet. And of course that advantages the machine, which means Hillary.
Believe me, they know what they're going to get. And they're going to put up this delegate thing, like phone cards or the people who are well known names. And
you're a Democratic committee man, do you have
fun? I'm a committee man. I'm the former executive director of the Democratic Party in Erie County of Virginia.
I've heard your name.
You have?
Yeah.
Oh,
that's scary.
You know what my name is?
Yeah, usually they say that.
No. I said I was the executive director. I'm not as old as Jim.
You're not Jim.
And your hair is better.
And I got more hair.
What's your name?
David Fath.
Okay.
Google me. I'm sure you'll find on Google.
When you hear his name, they usually say that S.O.B. Right.
Yeah, I've heard that one.
Okay, now that you say it that way.
Yeah. How you
but the super delegates are all going to go for Hillary.
thing that we want to see, two kind of things we want to see, just like-minded people. I'm sure if we get around with like, one issue, we'll hear our issues and other people report another. So the two big things I want to see here is, if there's a chance for you to meet like-minded people, exchange phone numbers, friend them on Facebook, share email addresses. And get you guys on this list here so I can send you out thank you notes and regular updates on what's going on. That way when we do we can stand on the ballot, we need to mobilize our efforts. If that's something you're interested in involved with or telling friends and family, get on.
They all have some progressive ideas about it. And the government will be better than people. And, the government shouldn't be here for corporations.
Corporations are people too, man.
You know what? Listen. I think you want the other meeting. It's just down the block. At least a month left. You'll hear people screaming.
Right, exactly.
Are you Dave?
I think the exciting thing is we want to get people not just involved in this, but this is going to be an opportunity to stay involved. And we can, you know what, we can make things a lot better.
We can do things by the piggyback on that. And what we talked about Sunday night was the fact that if we have enough people who want to see change occur, and you can get involved in the local Democratic Party, Dave's a committeeman, Pete's a committeeman. You can get a bunch of like-minded, progressive, non-party, is that the right term now?
Something, you know, countywide, and then work from there to do it, you know, statewide or
We all remember the Occupy movement, which was really a movement saying, look, something wrong when we're focused on Wall Street, not Main Street. And you know what the problem is there? Those people, when asked to get involved politically, said, I don't want to be part of that. I said, you don't seem to understand. Unless you're willing to be a revolutionary and pick up a gun, violence and change things, you either have a political process. You can do your own personal thing to try to change it. Because you either pick up a gun and change it revolutionarily, or you say, you know what, I'm going to work with the Democratic process to give it effect.
And that was the problem with the Occupy Unit movement. They didn't want to do anything within the structure that.
But even, I'm sorry, even before that, how many of you guys were aware of the Occupy movement and you were supporters of what they were talking about? Their big ideas. By a show of hands. How many?
I gave him a pizza downtown.
So,
two sheet pizzas.
So we all saw a lot of good in what they were doing, raising awareness of the issues. We saw economic inequality right now. We wouldn't be talking about the Occupy movement. But discussing the issues, and this is something that you know has changed for me in the last year. At the beginning of the year, I was a registered Republican voting for Carrie Turner.
It worked.
You know, voting for Carrie Turner. A resident senator, you know. The system's not going to change. Why try? Fuck it. That's my thing. In the last year, I've met like-minded people. I've registered in a party for pragmatic purposes. I'm working with like-minded people to make electoral change. These two here have taught me a lot about how the petitioning process works and how local electoral politics functions. That's great stuff. You know, that's not something I learned at school. I didn't learn it from my family. I can't speak for most of you, but a lot of people are in my boat. They get no political education at home. They don't get it at school. Nobody teaches them how to get involved. And I'm a graduate of Buffalo State College of History and Social Studies. Before going to college, I didn't have much of a political education at all. I'm just like, fuck it, burn it down. Does that work? Does that get us the change we want? No. Fuck it, burn it down isn't that work, you know?
we need to be much more
And
advantage.
Don't vote. Did you vote before? Have you voted?
Oh, I always vote. I have voted.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. You can write in, you know. And I have to admit, today I wrote again this time for the Erie County Legislature. Do you want to know why? We have
you didn't like Joe Larigo, that's why.
No, I was in Patrick Pierre in 7. So, okay. There were 14 races on the ballot in that I voted on today. 7 of those were unopposed.
Yeah.
Unopposed.
Most ballots, you only had 2 choices. There may be 10 races, but you're going to have 2 choices if you voted or if you voted both.
So there was a judge race. You can pick 2 people for judge.
And
right?
There were 2 runners.
There were only 2 runners. So you really have a choice. And, I mean, you can ask first if you need a choice, sure. But more importantly, there wasn't a choice. Unless you wrote somebody in. That's not
the way that works. What's amazing is the way that works is it's become more economical for the party chairman, by the way, to cut a deal and take care of the friends.
And have a race.
And to have a race.
And
the only time you get this and I get that.
The only time you have a race is when there's an odd number of candidates running. So last year there were 5. Dems took 2, reps took 2, and then they said, okay,
and it was 1 race.
Yes, right. You know what? We live in a Democratic county.
Yeah.
And you know, I live in a town of Tonawanda, and I have the second in the nomination of Judge Gruber for town judge. Democrat. The reason I did that is because that's what cross endorsement is supposed to, I don't say reward, but it's supposed to.
Next, we'll be canvassing door to door. As many as we can, but that's not for like another month or so.
The more engaged we are in this, the better we do.
I'd like to give a little patriotic speech about this. I believe that passing petitions is the civilian equivalent to going into combat. As Dave indicated, you know, passing petitions to put people on the ballot is very boring, it's very tedious, it's very hard work. But it is the highest level of expression of constitutionally protected free speech. What good is your vote if I get to determine who you get to vote for? What good is your vote for Supreme Court judge this year or county court judge? I mean, it's totally meaningless. I was just out in West Seneca. You can vote for the supervisor in West Seneca. That's it. So people are coming in for one position because all the other positions are decided already. If this organization can put together a group of people who will pass petitions in their own neighborhood, where they live, and if there's 50 people who get 50 signatures on a regular basis for candidates, we can run people for county executive next year or next time out. We can do all sorts of things, and we will be a group of people being contended with. If you want to run with the Democratic County Committee, we'll show you how. What you'll find astounding is people come out, they're activists, and they say, I've never heard of who my committeeman is. Well, the committeeman's supposed to be the person that is representing you in the Democratic County Committee. That's the person who's supposed to be casting petitions to your house. If you don't know who they are, there's something drastically wrong.
And you probably have a favorite committee that someone put in there. just so they show up with an endorsement.
And that's all they're expected to do. But you know, I mean, this is the most patriotic thing you can do.
You know,
it's a pain in the neck. It's not fun, it's tedious, and it's going to be particularly bad if we're out in the summer in January. It's going to be really ugly.
You also don't need 50
Let's say we have 50 people in the congressional. Let's say we have 50 people in the congressional. Guess what? We're at the minimum. We got 20 each. We get a double. You get a double in the signatures. You can assure. As long as they're good. So, okay. Yeah, okay. We can't have garbage. You can't go to the Broadway market and stand there and say, are you a Democrat? Would you like to sign my petition? Somebody walking in and say, hey, are you registered? Oh, I'm a Democrat. No, that's what that person feels like.
So you'll get to the street order, they'll have their name, the address, their age, their phone number, letter, an indication as to whether they're regular voters or not. No, they'll be a prime voter indicator. So, you know, we'll have better information than headquarters has, because I can show you what headquarters has, and it sucks to be quite frank.
But if we put together a group of people who can do that, we'll be a group to be contended with. So one way or the other, I mean, this is a tough state for us, obviously. Everyone is conceding New York State to Hillary Clinton. That doesn't mean that we don't organize and we don't put up a good show and build an organization. By the way, we've been doing this for 48 years, Ellen and I, okay? We haven't killed us yet, so, you know. I mean, it isn't that horrible. And, you know, if you do it in your own neighborhood, you get to meet your neighbors. You participate in the community. There's nothing wrong with that.
The other thing here is, by the way, folks, this should be for me. This isn't for me. This should be for me. It's part of my experience. But it's also fun. You meet people, have a good time. You know what? Makes me say, hey, we're trying to make the world better.
Social Security, one guy that forced that, it, it,
escaped it, but so many people helped. You know? And that's the role that each of us can play, to help shape all the kind of change we want to see. You know, we might not be in the history books, and frankly, cares if we are or not. You know, it would be nice to have that prestige, but you don't get there unless you start from, it's like that movie, I start from the bottom, and I don't know if you've ever seen that. Yeah, you know, you got to start from the bottom to get a certain degree of success.
Everybody on that list, with everybody's email on it,
so you can feel like, hey, connect with me once. Ask questions, talk to them. Let's know what we've done. Now, is that okay with everybody?
As far as me,
because what I can do is always pass the list around if you don't want to share. Just put a little star next to